Truthfully, this is Victoria and I'm here with your daily energy update. Coming to you from Kea Beach in Cook Island, Hawaii. It might get a little noisy today just because I'm so close to the ocean, but hopefully not too much. Hopefully you enjoy this update. Coming right from Mother Earth here. Me sitting on lava rock and embracing basically all the four elements, because lava rock represents fire as well as the sun. Then we have for the ocean to represent water, plenty of earth just here, and we have the wind, which is air. So hopefully that's gonna be a useful setup for our reading. And this is gonna be a classic read, so yeah, let's get started. As always, I'm starting with an oracle deck. Isn't the sacred traveler? It's so classic to me these days that I already forgot. Yeah, anyways, I am gonna start with an oracle card for each of the twins and then we'll continue with tarot. Hope you guys are doing great. Me, for one, I'm so happy that the rainy days are over, at least for a little while. I was so tired of it. And actually, as I was leaving Kona yesterday, it was pouring rain for like 3 hours. It was not fun. I don't like the rainy weather at all. Okay, so Divine Feminine has got Voyage of the Heart and Rainbow Blessings. Love flows through you and to you, and blessings are showering your life. So both cards to me actually represent this flow of energy. And speaking of rainbows, actually both of them have rainbow colors if you look here. So one is talking about love, the other one is talking about blessings, which actually is a good reminder how connected those things are. Because whenever we are in the flow with the energy of love, with the energy of kindness, compassion, and connection to everything, right? The Lord oneness definitely is a manifestation of that love energy. That's when the energy starts flowing in terms of our abundance in all its forms, our health and wellness. It immediately has effect on it. And yeah, this is showing that there is so much greatness and so much beautiful energy coming in for the Divine Feminine. As long as you're staying in the flow. And yeah, I love that the rainbow color is actually in both of them. So expect miracles. Usually those are the colors, right? That represent miracles. Stay in that high vibe space. Looks like everything is looking pretty good. So just stand in there. Actually put the rest of my cards behind me. I'm sincerely hoping they're not gonna fly away while I'm doing this. Yeah, it's interesting. I haven't done an outside reading for a while now, so need to remind myself some ground rules. And yeah, I know you can't really see my eyes, but the sun is pretty high already, and I don't want to get... Well, you know, the other option would be wearing sunglasses, in which case you can also not see my eyes. This way, at least, I have headwear that protects my head from getting a... What's it called? Kind of in a heat stroke. I was looking for another word, but let's say heat stroke. Yeah. The sun is pretty intense today. I can't wait to do some sunbathing. And also, I've got my snorkel here, so I'll be also doing some snorkeling. Check out on the fish. See how those guys are doing. Okay, so Divine Masculines have got solitude. In silence, peace prevails. So this is a big time for calming the mind, even if you don't have a chance to actually be by yourself physically in your life. It's important to at least quiet the mind and be able to listen to yourself and sort of like come back to center, right? Understand if something is bothering, what it is. If not, then acknowledge that peace, right? In silence, peace prevails. That's when we can acknowledge it really. Not when we hustle around doing this and that on a daily basis, but when we're actually in that moment of silence and we can feel it in our bodies, basically. and then we can really appreciate it for how much it means and how much it does to us, to our life. If there is a chance to get into a more solitude space, to be by yourself, to give yourself headspace, what to say, to give yourself time and space to be free and just follow your instincts, follow your body, follow your heart space in terms of what you want to do, where you want to go, that would be a really potential. Yeah, I got distracted a little. It's funny because actually when I'm on the beach, but I went to a very like distant location on the beach, specifically so that people, you know, I'm not around and I can be here with you guys by myself without any disruptions. And of course, as soon as I got landed here, you know, wearing something bright, people noticed and they started making their way this way. Come on, guys. Happens all the time to me. I do have another space that I like here. It's kind of secluded, but more like up the beach. And it's great for the hammock. And also there is like one tiny slot that would be great to do readings in, but I kind of got here late today, so it's still morning, but you know, late enough. There were some other people there, so it was occupied. And of course, for me, the priority is always to find that space where I can be in solitude and focus on the channelings for you guys. So yeah, I got all this way to the Lava Rocks thinking, okay, nobody ever walks this way. It's a long way. Sorry. But they did. On this note, let's move on to tarot. So I'm gonna use the Lightseer's tarot to see what's going on with the energies of Divine Feminine, first of all. Let's see what's going on with Divine Feminine. Ooh, the High Priestess, I love it. To me, it's a continuation of those rainbow-colored blessings. See this energy flow that is directly going into her crown chakra. Any clarifications? But she's got closed eyes, so I would say there's still a big focus on listening to your heart, following your instincts. That's critical. Not following what makes sense, what is a good idea, logically, but following your heart intentions. We got Two of Pentacles and Four of Cups. Because I'm limited with space, I'm gonna do the reading, the interpretation as I get the cards out. So again, it's about, look at that rainbow, more rainbow colors in this Four of Cups, right? So there is a chance, if you don't listen to your heart, that you would be sorry later on, because it would feel like a missed opportunity, and it would feel like, you know, you had your options, you had that knowledge, but you missed the window of opportunity. So right now is the time, whatever it is it your business projects, is it your relationship with someone, is it finding a new place to live, is it planning some travel, you know, whatever, maybe just doing some, like, dedicated some time to yourself, taking care of yourself. Maybe you have a chance to go to a spa weekend with a friend and you are on the fence because you already have some other commitments, right? Like, this is a little hint. If you are, if it's something good, but you're like on the fence because you have doubts, because logically it doesn't make sense to you, or you understand you have some obligation, do it. This is the time to just go and do it. If it feels right, it is right. Just go with that. Otherwise, there will be an additional, so you won't do the good thing that will make you feel good, but also there will be an additional layer of the sadness of missed opportunity. And then, of course, naturally, you'll have to work with that energy to release that. I like optimizing, you know. I've done project management for 12 years, so I like optimizing as much as possible. I'm like, why do all of this back and forth, right? If you can just go with the good thing. And maybe somebody will be disappointed, but so what? Your priority in this life, in this space, is your own happiness above anything else. I'm gonna say it again. Your priority in this life is your own happiness above anything else and anyone else. No one can do it for you. That's the obligation that you have to yourself. Okay, actually I needed that deck again to get the masculine energy. Sorry guys, this stone is pretty tricky, it's not straight, so I have to be careful. Okay, let's see what we have for Divine Masculines at this time. Eight of Wands and King of Pentacles. Yes, for the masculines, some communication is coming in to confirm that they are on track with their plans. Business plans, most likely, could be also connected with family plans. But something a little more pragmatic, you know, like, I don't know, buying a car, doing a renovation project, maybe moving kids to a new school or getting money for college payments, right? That can be a little bit larger than just like, do I get extra money or not? Is this project gonna work out or not, right? But yeah, that's the main idea here, is there is certain acknowledgement, official acknowledgement, official communication that things are coming together for DMs. It's still, there's still a bit of a challenge to recognize and be appreciative of it. That's what I'm getting here, right? Recognize how much work has been put into it by Divine Masculine and by other people involved, and be appreciative of it. And what I'm getting immediately is that moment of silence and solitude that we just spoke about. That's actually the space to express that gratitude, because it wasn't an easy gig. It wasn't straightforward, and this success should be recognized. And not just recognized by, I don't know, going out and having a few drinks, but doing that acknowledgement to people involved and, if possible, to the higher power involved. Okay, I'm gonna get another deck and we'll get some messages between the twins. It's getting pretty hot, it's a hot day. Still gonna shuffle a little bit. Okay, so first I'm gonna get messages from Divine Masculine to Divine Feminine. I'm trying to adjust my robe, but it's, you know, there's a bit of a breeze, so it keeps like flaring out. DMs to DFs. What would DMs like to say to their DFs at this time? Ooh. Two of Wands and Eight of Swords. Wow. So Divine Masculine's on the verge of a big step in their life, and they understand that that is a kind of a decisive step that you cannot undo easily. So you cannot unsee it, you cannot undo it, you cannot pretend that didn't happen or apologize or do something else. And they understand the pressure of it. Somehow it will impact the connection, and of course this is a collective reading, so I cannot cover all the scenarios, but it's almost like, you know, I'm gonna move to a different country. And I understand that I'm not gonna see my DF on a regular basis like I am now. Or I'm proposing to my karmic girlfriend, a boyfriend, and I understand that that means certain doors will be closed for me and my TF, something like that. And there is certain inner conflict about it. It's not an easy decision. So I guess this is the main message. I don't know if they're gonna make it. It's still sort of like in the limbo state, but there is a good chance they will. And that will disrupt somehow communication between the twins. And the main point in this message is that this is not an easy decision. And I want you to know, Divine Feminines, that they are sorry and it was tough for them to make. But they felt at that moment that that's the best thing to do. They had their reasons and they had to go with this. Okay? Now, messages from Divine Feminines to Divine Masculines. I sincerely hope you can hear me through the ocean and the waves, but it's not actually, it's not too loud. Because of all the rocks, the waves keep breaking, so I don't really get big waves close to the shore. And of course, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I appreciate all of your likes, guys. It's special for me, so please don't forget to do that. It's important. It's a high priestess, actually. Pentacles. Yeah, so Divine Feminine is saying, you know, she's in the flow right now and she feels really good about continuing with her mission, continuing with light work, and continuing to see ways to help people and to implement their giftings, their skills. So that's the focus right now. Connection to nature in both of them, animals and plants, big topic these days. So Divine Feminine may be finding inspiration in the nature, which is funny to say as I'm doing this reading right here, in the wild. but yeah, it's true. So they want to say that I want you to know that I'm doing great, I'm doing well, I'm focusing on what is the priority for me, you know, after taking care of myself, which is really about mission and light work. And I'm getting this energy of being boastful a little bit, of bragging a little. They want to brag a little to Divine Masculine about the certain insights, certain success, and it doesn't have to be specific steps in like light worker career, let's put it that way, right? It can even be some insights about their own life and their own blockages, but it does open doors for those extra opportunities in mission. And they're really happy about it and they want you, Divine Masters, to be happy for them. So please send them some good vibes of support. Okay, I hope this has been good for you guys. Thank you so much for joining me today here in the beautiful Kealakekua Bay, KAA Beach. And I'll be back with more readings very, very soon. And by the way, I will start recording my March readings on my other channel, March Horoscopes by Every Zodiac Sign. So yeah, you can be expecting something, I think starting tomorrow, some recordings show up on Mindful Bamboo channel. So check those out. Love you guys.